translation. And now it's time to introduce another former All Black in the shape of Eric Rush. Eric, thanks for coming in tonight. Now, we saw a very dull display by England. The conditions were slightly against them in the second semi-final, and so it's a tantalising prospect, isn't it? The dullness of England and the defence of Australia. I can see this one being a three-all draw at full time. What do you see as the view ahead for next Saturday night?
I think the Wallabies sort of won't be too worried about what they saw tonight, but... I guess, you know, there's a lesson that's been learned from this weekend that the favourite teams have been knocked over, so I don't think they're going to be too complacent.
Now, the other thing is Thursday night looms as a very big night for New Zealand football, doesn't it? The New Zealand rugby in particular.
We're actually looking for tickets because none of us planned on being there.
Now, will it be hard for the team to get up and take on France?
Oh, of course, it's always hard to get up and play the loser's game, you know, and that's what it is, really. And but, you know, these guys, they're wearing All Black jerseys and they're proud of that fact, so I'm sure they'll turn up.
And have you got a selection there? You know, I hate to put you on the spot here, being a New Zealander, do you think the boys can squeak past France and retain that smidgen of pride, or do you think that awaits them?
No, I think they're hooting after last night, so I think there's a type of guys in this team that will turn up and want to put on a good performance.
And do you have any contact in the team? Have you spoken to anybody in the team?
I spoke to a few of the guys last night, and none of them went out on the piss, surprisingly enough. But I guess the only reason for that was that they were playing on Thursday, otherwise they would have been blind.
Yes.
Roy!
<Yeah.
laughs>
What did they put the loss down to? Did they blame themselves, or was it just a superior opposition on the night?
Yeah, in 1999 we lost the semi-final to the French, and the whole country was gutted because for three quarters of that game we were all over them.
Yeah.
And then 20 minutes they just destroyed us. But last night we weren't in the game from the start, so I think we've accepted this loss a lot better than the last one. But the day you start accepting losses is a sad day, so we're still gutted, but you know, for us, I guess, the best team won, and that's the only way to describe it, so fair play to them.
Tana Amaga's loss, was he a key when he obviously went out injured earlier?
Yeah, Tana's a senior man in the team, and not so much by what he does on the field, but he inspires a lot of people around him.
Yes.
And, you know, it's those dreadlocks too, you know, it's... have you ever smelt them? They don't smell too nice, those things. <Yeah. laughs> So, you know, in the rucks it's a bit of a weapon, you know, so... but, you know, he was a big loss to the side, for sure.
Now, this test against the French, should it be... Could we call it a Rainbow Warrior test, do you think? to give it a little bit of import, you know?
Yeah,
would that be something you could suggest to the blokes to... remember the Rainbow Warrior?
The Rainbow Warrior is a bit of one of the things they've done. The other thing was all the bombs they let off in the Pacific.
Yes, the Muroa Atoll Rainbow Warrior test. Is that the way it could be sold?
On the other hand, they're in the World Cup longer than they were in the World War last time, so...
There's plenty of fuel there, Eric. That's for sure.
Now, better not say too much because they might bloody beat us too. So,
well, that's on the cards, mate. I hate to say it, but the way you played last night, less said the better. Look, yes, the way you played last night. Now you're more a sevens specialist, is that right, Eric?
Yeah, I've just played sevens the last few years, and we're actually the world champions of that, so we'll take that.
Now, why doesn't that create a lot of excitement back home? Because as far as I can tell, people aren't interested in the sevens all that much.
Right. You know, New Zealand is actually the under-19s, the under-21s, the sevens and the women, they're all world champion teams. But unfortunately for in New Zealand, the only team that matters is the All Blacks.
Yeah.
And they're the only team that hasn't fronted for a long time. So, but, you know, it's just a little part of the game in New Zealand. But whatever we do, we aim to do it well, I suppose.
Last time in the World Cup where you were knocked out by France, I think there was a fall of government very soon after. People wanted, you know, answers, and they thought this would, might have provided the answers. Can you see Helen Clark being under threat as a result of this World Cup performance, Eric? I mean, in your nation, this can happen, can't it?
Well, they blame the All Blacks for everything in their country, you know. If it's raining, they blame the blinging All Blacks. It's just part of being in their jersey, you know. You're treated like lords and stuff, I guess, when everything's going well. But when the proverbial hits the fan, you've got to take all of that stuff as well. So
will John Mitchell stay with the team, or like John Hart, will be he be given a quick?
Well, he said a couple of years ago, if he lost the World Cup, he'd be doing a lawn mowing round. So it'd be interesting to see if he backs up his wins.
Now, you're here on a big, apart from obviously watching the matches, Monday night is a big night. Apparently, it's a sort of a international rugby comedy festival. What's the go here? Is it...
The All Blacks turn up?
You guys haven't beaten England yet either, so... moment, we've both exactly won the same thing, absolutely nothing.
No, that's true.
I don't know how I got bloody talked into this comedy thing. Peter Fitzsimons... shit, my phone's vibrating.
That'll be Fitzy now, probably.
It's all Monday night, and I'm pegging myself, actually, because it's apparently about 2,000 people going along.
What's the nature of, what have you, committed yourself to? Like 15 minutes discussing, lineouts and the problem in the most hilarious manner possible? With video illustrations?
I actually just get up and take the piss out of my mates, basically. I don't know if the crowd enjoy it. I know my mates certainly don't enjoy it.
And do players actually say funny things while the game's on? I mean, we've got some vision here, I think, of George Gregan. And before we go to that vision, can I just say that Eddie, of course, had a number of tricks up his sleeve, and one was to get George talking. George has been very quiet this World Cup, but at least he let his gob do the talking last night. And here's a mouthful that he's given to, I think it's a Byron Gallagher here. I think the message is fairly easy to clear there, along the lines of four more years, Byron, four more years. that's not particularly funny, except to George, of course, and all Australians. But, can I say, do players actually say funny things while the game's on?
Oh, yes, there's plenty that goes on. Most of it you can't repeat in this sort of environment. But, even the refs crack the old funnies now and then. I remember Paddy O'Brien, the guy who riffed the game tonight, he told me that I was depriving a village of an idiot somewhere, you know. So I thought that was pretty good. But I actually turned around and said to him, you're going to go far as a referee, and the sooner you start, the better. So he saw the funny side of it.
Apart from getting the tripe beaten out of you, is it entertaining to play at this level, or does it become too serious to enjoy it?
No, I think that's the thing about footy. You know, those guys who were hooking into each other tonight, if it's the final, they'd all go out and have a beer together afterwards. And I think that's the great thing about rugby as a sport.
Well, Eric, thanks very much for coming in tonight, and good luck tomorrow night, of course, at the big comedy festival. And of course, you get a Stainer ensemble only available to people who come onto the cream on the House of Cheese. People have been concerned that the shorts were missing the stain. No, it's all there, and obviously goes with this magnificent jumper as well. And so, good luck with the night tomorrow night, and thanks very much for popping into the House of Cheese.